Hello everyone, welcome again in my class of CIS 3146 Embedded System. We are in week 5, as I said, part number 1, and in week 5 we are discussing on introduction to microcontroller, and this is part 2. In part number 1 we have completed the introductory detail about microcontroller. We will start this session by taking a quick look of aim and objectives. So we'll see what we have done in part 1 and what we are going to do in part 2. The overall aim for week 5 is introduction and applications of microcontroller. So far we have completed the introduction part. And in order to achieve this objective, as I showed in part number 1, I have framed 4 different objectives, and till now in part number 1 I have completed first objective. In this session, that is in part 2 of week 5, the focus is to cover objective 2. So I will be covering objective 2 in part 2 of week 5, and the remaining 2 objectives, that is 3rd and 4th objectives, I will cover in next part, that is in part number 3. So I will start this session, that is discussion on different types of microcontroller. So I have listed the types of microcontroller here. Microcontrollers are basically divided into various categories. I have highlighted 4 most popular categories in this slide. So first category is, you can classify microcontroller based on the memory. So one of the factor is memory. This is one of the factor to classify microcontroller. The second type is based on the architecture. You can classify microcontroller, or types of microcontroller can be identified based on the types of architecture used for the microcontroller. The next type of microcontroller can be identified based on the bits, so number of bits the microcontroller is processing. So you can say that 8-bit microcontroller or 16-bit microcontroller or 32-bit microcontroller, based on the bits. So number of bits can be one of the factor to classify the microcontroller. And the last category which I have enlisted in this slide is instruction set. So based on the type of instruction set, you can classify the microcontroller in this CISC instruction set or RISC instruction set. So based on the instruction, we can classify the microcontroller in 2 categories. One is CISC microcontroller or RISC microcontroller. We'll discuss these 2 in detail in the coming slides. So I will start the discussion on types of microcontroller based on the first type, that is based on the memory, and it is given in the next slide. So based on the memory, microcontrollers are classified in 2 classes. The first one is external memory based microcontroller and embedded memory based microcontroller. So this is the first type of microcontroller, that is external. So memory will be attached externally to the microcontroller. And the second type of microcontroller which is classified based on the memory is embedded memory microcontroller. So you can see memory will be embedded with the microcontroller. We will start, what is this? We will discuss first what is external memory microcontroller. So in this type of microcontroller is designed in such a way that they do not have a program memory chip with the microcontroller. So program memory chip, the chip which will store program, the program you will write and deploy on the microcontroller will be stored in a chip, And in this category of microcontroller, the memory chip will not be integrated with the microcontroller. So program, for storing the program, you need external memory, and then you will use the external memory for the microcontroller. So here it is given, like, hence it is named as external memory microcontroller, because you are using external chip to store the program, intelligent program, for controlling the microcontroller. The example for this category is Intel 8031 microcontroller. So Intel 8031 microcontroller, this type of microcontroller uses external memory chip, and that is the reason it is called as external microcontroller chip, and the example is Intel 8031 microcontroller. On the other hand, if we are talking about embedded memory based microcontroller, what will happen? Just reverse of this will come under this category. So here, this type of microcontroller is designed in such a way that microcontroller has all programs and data memory, counter, timer, interrupts, input output ports are embedded on the chip. So everything, all these things you will see, will be integrated with the microcontroller. The example for this category of microcontroller is 8051 microcontroller, which I showed you in the previous slide. Previous slide, I mean part 1 of week 5. So this is the example for external, and this one is the example for embedded memory chip microcontroller. Next, we will see bit based microcontroller. So the next type is bit based microcontroller. As far as bit based microcontrollers are concerned, there are three different types of microcontroller. The first one is 8-bit microcontroller. What it does, it performs all the arithmetic operations. So this type of microcontroller is used to perform arithmetic logical operations. So arithmetic operations are addition, you can perform, you can perform subtraction, you can perform multiplication, you can perform division, you can perform AND logical operator, like AND operation can be performed, OR operation can be performed, NOT operation can be performed, or any other combination which you can make using these logical operator can be performed using 8-bit microcontroller. And the example is 8031 microcontroller and 8051 microcontroller are 8-bit microcontroller. The next type of bit-based microcontroller is 16-bit microcontroller. So what it does, it performs almost the same task what 8-bit microcontroller does with more accuracy. So this type of microcontroller is used to perform arithmetic operation, logical operation, same 8-bit microcontroller does, but here you will get more accuracy and performance will be better than this, because here you can process a 16-bit in one go. The example for 16-bit microcontroller are 8096 is 16-bit microcontroller. The next type of bit-based microcontroller is 32-bit microcontroller. So this type of microcontroller is used to perform automatic control system. So it is used in automatic control system. So you can see this type of microcontroller is generally used in automatically controlled system. So any system which you are going to design and you want to get the feature of automatic feature, you want to embed in that system, then you can use 32-bit microcontroller. The example for this category is automatic operational machine, medical appliance or medical system, washing machine, and digital microwaves are the examples for 32-bit microcontroller. Next type of microcontroller is classified based on instruction set. So as far as instruction sets are concerned, there are two categories of microcontroller is given based on instruction set. The first category is CISC based microcontroller. So what is CISC? CISC stands for Complex Instruction Set Computer. And why we use it? It allows user to insert a single instruction as an alternative to multiple instructions. So rather than executing multiple instruction set I1 to IN, using CISC you can replace this completely. Rather than using n number of instruction to perform a task, you can use just one instruction, and this instruction will perform the same task what n number of instructions are doing, or multiple alternative instructions are, simple instructions are doing. So, but this instruction will be very complex and it will replace multiple alternative instructions, simple instructions. So that is the reason, due to the complexity involved with this instruction, it is referred as complex instruction set computer. So set is because it is the alternative for many instruction set, simple instruction set, and it is, the structure is very complex, so it is referred as complex instruction set computer. The next category is RISC microcontroller. So what is RISC? RISC stands for Reduced Instruction Set Computer. What it does? It reduces the operational time by shortening the clock cycle per instruction. So it improves, so if operational time is get reduced, so if time perform time is reduced to process instruction, so what is actually happening here? It is used to improve the performance of the system. So it improves the overall performance of the system by shortening the clock cycle per instruction. That's all in this session. Next, I will explain the applications of microcontroller, and then I will introduce you some of the popular microcontroller based system. So that's all in this session from my side. See you in the next part, that is in part 3 of week 5 on microcontroller. Thank you very much.